In the figure above, M and N are two points on the side PQ and PR of triangle PQR respectively, such that M and QR is a trapezium. Let's quickly discuss the properties of trapezium. In a trapezium, the two sides are parallel, they are unequal, and as long as these two sides are parallel, we understand angle P is common to these two triangles, which means I'm talking about triangle PMN and PQR. Angle M will be same as angle Q because they'll be corresponding angle, and angle N will be same as angle R. I have done the marking with all the equal symbols so that we can see which sides will be corresponding. We can say the ratio of the corresponding sides can be represented as PN over PR is equal to MN over QR is equal to PM over PQ. Now, MN over QR is equal to 2 by 5. MN over QR is equal to 2 by 5. So, the ratio of the sides is 2 by 5. Let's assume if it is 2x, then it is 5x. MN over QR. What is the ratio of area of triangle PMN to the area of trapezium MNQR? Now, ratio of areas of two similar triangles, because we know that triangle PMN is similar to triangle PQR, the ratio of areas is given by, we write it as A1 over A2, that is equal to ratio of corresponding side and the square of it, where ratio of corresponding sides is what we have written here. So, if we have to find out the area of triangle PMN over area of triangle PQR, then it should be equal to 2 over 5 whole square, that becomes 4 over 25. Now, that means if the area of this particular triangle is 4a, then the area of this whole big triangle is 25a. That means area of trapezium MNQR will be equal to 25a minus 4a, that is equal to 21a. Now, what we have to find out is area of triangle PMN divided by area of trapezium MNQR. So, that will be equal to 4a divided by 21a. So, the answer should be 4 over 21, which is option B. So now, the important part here was to know that the ratio of the areas of two similar triangles is represented by a square of the ratio of their corresponding sides. Let me quickly give you a background of this statement. That's because if you calculate the area of this triangle, it will have this base and this height. And if, okay, these two will be the bases and the height will be, let's call them AB. We can also say that PA will be corresponding to PB, and we know that the area of triangle PMN will be half of MN multiplied by PA, and area of the bigger triangle will be half of QR multiplied by PB. But we need to understand that PA upon PB is same as MN over QR, and now that we know that, we can quickly say that it is the ratio of areas is the ratio of corresponding sides and then square it, because the same ratio has been used here twice. I hope that makes sense, and I hope the learning was useful for you. Thank you so much.